Today, now I am discussing about the movement of supply curve, and this is also called the change in quantity supplied. Clear on this part? So there is a two part. One part is the extension of supply, and the next part is the contraction of supply. What is the meaning of extension of supply? Simply, extension of supply means when the price increase, the quantity supply to the market will be increased. So when price increase, supply will increase. And what is the contraction of supply? When price decrease, supply will be decreased. So when price increase, it will be supply. Say for example, S is the supply. So when price increase, supply increase. When price decrease, supply decrease. Now graphically you see how can I explain the concept. At first, I am going to the point extension of supply. See, this is a two-dimension curve. Here x o x dash and y o y dash are the two axes. Y o y dash denotes price in rupees, and x o x dash denote quantity supplied in units. Clear on this? For graphical explanation, at first you draw a supply curve. So here S is a supply curve, and see here the OP is the price of commodity, and when the price is OQ, then the quantity supplied in the market is OQ. Now, according to the concept of extension of supply, we know the price will be increased. If price increase from OP to OP1, then see what is the position of quantity supplied to the market. Automatically, you can determine. When price increase from OP to OP1, that means price increase from OP to OP1, then price, how much amount of price increase? The PP1, that means PP1 portion price is increased. Clear in this part? When price increase, then see quantity supplied from OQ to OQ1 means is that quantity supplied increased to the market OQ to OQ1. That means QQ1 portion supply is increasing. And see, when the original price was OP, then the point was A, and when price increase from OP to OP1, then the point A move to the point B, upward movement. As the quantity supply increase from Q to Q1, that is why price move from A to B point. This is called the extension of supply. Clear on this part? Now I am going to the contraction of what? Okay. for the contraction of what? The same way I can explain this concept. X O X dash and Y O Y dash. Both are the X axis and Y axis. So the vertical axis I denote the price of commodity in rupees, and vertical axis we denote quantity supplied in units. Okay. Same way, you draw a supply curve S S. Okay. When the price is OP, then see the quantity supplied to the market is OQ at the point A. It's very simple. Now, according to the contraction concept, if price decreased, then supply will be reduced. So, if price decreased from OP to OP2, that means if price reduced from OP to OP2, OP to OP2, that means PP2 portion price is reducing. For the reduction of price from OP to OP2, how much amount of quantity reduced? How much amount is OQ to OQ2? So OQ to OQ2, that means QQ2 portion quantity supplied is reducing. And see, the point A move to the point C. Now see, when the original price was OP, original quantity supplied was OQ. When price reduced from OP to OP2, that means PP2 portion price is reducing, then the quantity supplied is also reducing from OQ to OQ2, and then point A move to the point C. So this is called the contraction of supply. Now I am adding the extension and the contraction concept together with, then you can get the entire concept of the movement of supply. Okay. Now see the steps. So X O X dash and Y O Y dash price in rupees, and here is quantity supplied in units. Clear? And S S is the supply curve. Now see, when the price is OP, then the quantity supplied is OQ at the point A. So clear in this part? Now, when price increase from OP to OP1, increasing, price increase from OP to OP1, we know if price increased, then quantity supplied automatically decrease. Sorry. When price increase from OP to OP1, then automatically quantity supply will be increased from OQ to OQ1. increasing. And due to that, the price, due to that, the point A moved to the point V. So again, I am repeating. When price increased from OP to OP1, then quantity supplied increased from OQ to OQ1, and the point A moved to the point B. As the quantity supply increased due to the increase of prices, this is called extension. Extension of supply. Similarly, when the price reduced from OP to OP2, means when price reduced, then automatically quantity supplies reduced from OQ to OQ2. That means quantity supplied reduced to the market, and due to that the point A moved to the point C. Due to the price of decrease from OP to OP2, the quantity supplied reducing from OQ to OQ2. That is why the point A is also moving to the point C. So this concept is called contraction of supply. So clear on this part. Now I am discussing shortly how you can draw this curve. At first you draw either extension or contraction of the curve. Then similarly you draw the another curve, extension or contraction. Then you mix up the extension and the contraction curve in a single diagram. So then automatically you can get the movement of supply. Clear? Bye.